Recording if it'll let me. Oh, there it goes. Hold on. There we go. Okay. So we are back. Forza 2. C-Class, which the community chose. Wait for it. And as in the community, I mean people in the Strawpolls, which are still are more in the description below. Hopefully. As long as I remember them this time, because last time I had an issue with remembering them. We are using this car, the 2005 Mustang GT, because that's what the people chose. So we are going to use it. Which I think this car is a ridiculous body kit in this game. It has like a Celine body kit, and I just went to the wrong thing. Let's see. So we gotta get this up to C550. Oh yeah. Oh, we have a bunch of body kits. Oh yeah. I like that one. Let's make it look as stupid as possible. Pretty much. And I'll leave the stock spoiler. I don't like the Celine spoiler at all. I do like the Celine bumper. But that just adds that, okay. I can't really see what's going on. No, it's got a diffuser. Also, it's really low on the sides. Hello, Antics. Welcome to the stream. We're going to use a Celine rear bumper because why not? That only adds 5 pounds. How does that only add 5 pounds? I would use a Celine one, but I'm going to use this one. Yes, that is a horse running on the front end of the car, believe it or not. And there's only one hood, so I'll use that one. Also, remove weight, which is nice. Dirt and Grid Autosport. Grid Autosport's pretty awesome, honestly. The AI is kind of ridiculous, but other than that, it's pretty awesome. Wow, coming in strong with the insults, I can see. Dirt is in like Dirt 1 or Dirt 3 or Dirt 2. Because there's many there's many Dirt games. I don't know, I kind of want to use some inset wheels for this car. Ooh. Fisk has some good ones. I like these. Okay, bye. After just coming in being dumb. 18s. Let's use 19s. Okay. So now that we've done the stupid part of the customization, which is exterior, let's upgrade some other stuff. Oh, Dirt 3, okay. Yeah, because I was like, there's five? Yeah, there's five Dirt games now. Don't care about that. Transmission. We're just going to do this one. Also, I get things. B. Patrick, what? Let's remove some weight, because, hey, Mustang! Let's just do 396 pounds. Okay, now engine upgrades. Oh, look at that! Absolutely perfect. No boost from the Mustang, because why not? Okay, so the Mustang is upgraded to C550. Now we shall paint it. Hello, higher viewer count? Holy shit. It just went like from like one viewer to four viewers. Okay, paint car. This car actually looks pretty damn good in red. But, I have a feeling it'll look better as a metallic kind of blue. Almost like, ooh, I do actually kind of like that one. Oh, B. Patrick. Ooh, there's like special color. Oh wait, there are special colors in this game. Is there a matte color? I can't remember. All these colors are way too dark. Ooh, I like that. Green. Also, how stupid is the stock spoiler with the Celine potty kit? That's retarded. I kind of like that one actually. Let's go with that one. We're going to, of course, make the wheels darker colored. Okay, so we have a Mustang. Let's do the C-Class Endurance Race. Hopefully this will go well like the last one. Dark gray, but not black. Interesting. Endurance races. Alrighty, Mazda Raceway Laguna Seca. for I don't know how many laps. I didn't actually pay attention. I probably should have. But we're going to go for it. I think I'm going to put the difficulty on hard. Since we won, but had won by so much on the PT Cruiser one on medium. So we're going to put it, oh, hard is the hardest. Okay. I thought there was, I guess professional wasn't in this game. I think that may have came in like Forza 3 or something. Ooh, I'm racing against a Caddy, an Evo, a Lotus. Caddy, man. Caddy Shack. Hello, Q. Welcome to the stream. Okay, brakes are okay. I didn't actually upgrade my tires at all. I just didn't realize that. That may suck, but for now it's going to be okay. Never seen any gameplay of Forza 2 until now. Well, congratulations on your first Forza 2 gameplay viewing-age. Yes, it's a very nice Celine. If only I could remove the spoiler, it would be so much better. Like, this game doesn't have that though. I think that came in Forza 4, which makes me really upset. Because I can't take the stupid stock spoiler off. Also, I'm winning by a ton already. Pizza. I had toast raviolis like an hour ago. Oh hey, Lotus is being Yes, the Lotus is being So this is the last time I'm gonna have to race in this track in this game, which makes me extremely happy. No, it doesn't have every Michelin option. It doesn't have the side. It doesn't have the spoiler, side skirts, or front bumper. It does have the wing, but it's stupid looking. Like, honestly, the Celine wing is so bad. Speaking of which, there's actually a Celine of this generation on this game. Oh, balls. Okay, I'm good. Oh god, this thing does not turn whatsoever. Probably should have done some stuff to the handling, but oh well. I did put springs on it, or suspension, basically. I could use tires, but whatevs. We have big wheels. We have a slim body kit. Yeah, I know. I've driven this track in almost every series in this game, and I'm tired of it. I don't know. I don't like any of the wings that come on this car, especially the Forza wing. The big ass one. The Slim Wing is just the worst to me, honestly. Oh god. I'm still winning somehow, so that's nice. What happened? Somebody just went live on Twitch. My phone lit up. Okay, so 30 laps. Whatevs. Oh, jeez. Nearly into the race? Into what race? This race? You like big wings and big tires in Forza Motorsport 2. Oh god. Oh god. Yeah, it's a standard Mustang. It's a 05 Mustang GT with a Celine rear bumper, which makes the back end of the car like 10 inches longer. And puts the exhaust in the middle, which I like. I always like center exhaust. Also, this is going to actually be a close race. Unlike the PT Cruiser one, where I just fucking dominated. Yeah, graphics have come really far in the last 8 years. Considering this game was came out, this game was came out. This game came out 8 years ago. As of last May. Yeah, man, Dirt and Grit are amazing. Cody's makes some great games. Let's see, what is the PI? Huh, 549, 536. I like how the lease got passed by a WRX STI. Like, good job, Lotus. PT loser. Oh! Also, I'm doing terrible laps because I keep going off the track. It's gonna be one of these endurance races. I'm just gonna, like, race and then I'm gonna crash on the last lap and then lose. I know it. I know it's gonna happen sometime. I just know it. I don't think I've actually gotten a clean lap since. Well, actually, I don't think I've gotten a clean lap at all in this race. A, because of the car, and B, because of the track. I have no fault in this. Okay, so I'm gaining a little bit of time. Yeah, so this is already kind of a retro game, honestly. Since there's no cars newer than 2008 on it. Which is always kind of weird to just kind of go back and be like, oh, 2007 Audi Quad or Audi TT was brand new whenever this game came out. This car was only 2 years old when this game came out. This generation of Mustang, which we've had two more generations of Mustang after this. Well, I don't know if it's two generations, but we had the 2010 and 2014 ones, and now the new 2015 ones. And it's like this car was brand new whenever Forza 1 came out. Hey, look at that. 1 minute 40 lap time. I can play racing games if I'm on YouTube. I got 2,000 subscribers. Come sleep with me. Yeah, 1.5 generations, kind of. Hello, Elite Clasher. Welcome to the stream. Because I don't really know if there's anything really completely 100% different between this generation and then, like, the 2010 to 2014s. Because they look basically the same, besides different... Way different front end and back end, but everything else is just about the same. Classic racing game problems, I know, right? Like, if you play a classic, like, RPG or something, like, oh. I think it was a joke, Michael. Don't worry about that. Because I don't think saying I put up... complete racing games and have 2,000 subscribers on YouTube is going to get any girl, to be completely honest. Oh god. Yeah, this is a live stream. Because YouTube actually has decent live streaming now. So I don't know what lap I'm going to have to pit on, because I know I'm going to have to pit in this race. I know it's going to be too long. Like, the D-Class one was close. And this track's nearly twice as long as Tsukuba. And has nearly as many laps. Well, kind of. Somebody's triggered. Oh, God. My car's kind of dirty. You can't really tell with this paint. Hell yeah, cool stream. Because I'm a cool dude. Puts on sunglasses. Okay, I turned in a little bit too late. Okay, this car really sucks at handling. but I'm still winning on hard difficulty, so I'm not complaining at all. Forza 2 is really good. I mean, that's why I've spent nearly 100 episodes playing through it on my YouTube channel. Trust me, I would have stopped by now if it was a bad game. Tsukuba Matata. God damn it. You can really tell the front end of my car is dirty. The back end, you can't really tell. And the sides, it's not, you can kind of tell. What a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata. I want to watch The Lion King, damn it. It means no worries for the rest of your days. It's a problem free. As I break into song. I watched The Lion King 1.5 not too long ago with some friends. And that's like the last time I've seen The Lion King since like 2008, maybe. Maybe probably earlier, actually. So how about Iron Giant coming back to theaters for like 2 weeks or something? This game does not have interior view, it just has hood view, sadly. PlayStation consoles, yeah. It does not. I would probably actually be using the interior view, except for people who get angry with me because they can't see the car. If it had it. Okay. So I'm slightly ahead of my split time, apparently, and this Cadillac is being the one that is going to ultimately just destroy everything. Also, what car is M. Rossi in? M. Rossi is in 5th place. Get wrecked, nerd. Yeah, interior view started with Forza 3. In 2009. Hey, look at that. Best lap time. I also got under a minute 40, which is nice. I like how there's license plate lights underneath the third brake light, except for the fact that there's not going to be a license plate there because that's where the gas cap is, and that's where the GT badge is. So I don't know if that's a mistake on turn 10's end for modeling that way, or if it's a mistake on Celine's end for doing that. Although I don't see anywhere else where a license plate would go on this car, so it may be there in the Celine's. I don't know. I don't know where you put the gas cap then. I'm pretty sure it's a gas cap. No, it isn't. Never mind. I'm stupid. So you just put it there. Okay. Never mind. I'm thinking about like old Mustangs, like 70s and 60s Mustangs. Online servers should still be up, I think. They were at least, like, a couple months back. There's nobody on them, but they were still up. I mean, there's not any tournaments or auction house or anything like that anymore, but I'm pretty sure there's still multiplayer. Okay. You want to test my drive? Yeah, that is a big, fast Cadillac. Is that Jay Davis? Yeah, it is. Hey, I know. Why did I ask myself that when his name's on the bottom left corner saying he's in second place? Or why did I go to the pause menu? I forget about things sometimes. So yeah, I think this race is going to take, actually, holy shit, let's see after, right after I finish the 10th lap, let's see where I'm at, and that'll probably be how long it'll take the race. Well, besides a pit stop, but. I'll have to look at that. Because I thought the servers were still up for multiplayer, but if not, that is deeply saddening, because I was looking to play some of this online just before, we probably don't find a match because there's no people playing it. Like, I found one person, I think, that was a random, and whoever I was trying to play with, I think it was Mr. HD, on the multiplayer months ago, but there was nobody else. Definitely not 32 minutes. Or is it 32 more minutes, you're saying? Because this is definitely not going to take 32 minutes total. Hello, Jack. Welcome to the stream. Okay. There's a blue bird on the bottom of my screen. Oh no! Yeah, Q, I was like, wait, that math does not add up. Okay, at the end of this lap, just multiply whatever by 3. 49 minutes? Okay. Bad news bears. Okay. Stay in front of Mr. Cadillac, man. We shall be good. But after this, we get to do A class, because I already did B class, like, a long time ago. So, yay, fast cars. I think it's to be around 52-ish minutes. Because that was about what the D-class one was. And I think B-class was actually about the same as that also. I mean, these are kind of endurance races. But they're pretty much not. Because, like I was saying in the last one, it's like, oh, I could do the 9-hour roadster race on Gran Turismo 5, while I can only do a 45-minute endurance total. Well, actually, I don't know about later ones, but 45 minutes for the early ones on this game. I'd rather not make a bet myself. You guys can bet amongst yourself in the chats, I guess. I'm not gonna... Well, yeah, I probably will end the stream after this race. Because I have to, I'm not going to edit this because I'm lazy and I need to record something else for tomorrow. That fuel one can't Strawpoll? Why can't Strawpoll? Wait. Hold on. My Elgato's derping out. I just realized. God damn it, Elgato. Why do you always reset yourself to fucking 30 FPS? There we go. Now it's smooth. I want 720p60, damn it. That's the only problem with streaming that I have, is that this fucking capture card doesn't work worth a jack shit for streaming-wise, because it resets itself and it lags like a mofo. I mean, I'm not going to be right after this race, I'm going to stop the stream. I'm probably going to do a few more things afterwards, like buy cars and things, and then end the stream. But yeah, very overbeating. I couldn't make a Strawpoll because I don't want to pause the stream for any longer than I have to. OBS is having issues with... Everything has issues with the HD60. Like, fucking XSplit has issues. Yes, Jacker's covered with poo-poo. Well, that's probably in the settings somewhere, Antics. I don't know. But... The HD60 Elgato does not work with OBS right. It doesn't work with XSplit right. It doesn't work with OBS multi-platform right, which is what I'm using. I mean, it does work right, but you have to set it up like every single time you stream. Yeah. I'd much rather have an AverMedia like Live Gamer or something, but that's another money that I don't have, plus the fact that it only does 720p at 60 FPS, and because Master Race, blah 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 blah, I want 1080p at 60 FPS, but for streaming I could probably handle 720p just because. Oh, God damn it. Oh, I didn't even look at my time, so it's gonna be, yeah, we've already decided it's gonna be somewhere around 50-ish minutes. Get out. That is a weird face that they put for Kappa. Like, what were you thinking, YouTube? Seriously. I mean, I know you wanted a Kappa emote because, hey, Twitch and stealing people from Twitch and things, and yeah. But that's a very dumb face. 1440p at 180 FPS. Funny part is I actually want a 1440p monitor that can do 144Hz, aka 144fps and stuff. Just because. Yeah, out of all the emojis, like, what? What is YouTube even doing? I mean, at least they have some kind of emojis. Or else life would not be the same, but they could have picked better ones. Like, take Fwiz's face or something and put it, make it black and white and put it as a Kappa, although that would probably be copyright issues. I don't know, but... Oh, God. Cadillac man, do not pass me. Okay. Like, yeah. Like, my Elgato, even the HD60, just recording at 1080p at 30fps, half of my files get corrupted if I don't turn off the preview. And I used to record at 1080p perfectly fine on the Elgato Game Capture HD, and it was fucking just wonderful. But no, HD60, you gotta fucking take up all of my high-end, somewhat high-end i5. In my desk, do stuff with my knees now. Hello, Junior Fan, welcome to the stream. I should probably start paying attention to race more, because I could probably actually get, like, way ahead of this Cadillac, but I keep looking over the chat. Yeah, there could definitely be a better Kappa than the one we have now on YouTube. But, you know. Also, Forza 6 demo in, like, 2 days, which is fucking bingles. Fucking bingles. GBA and N64 games on your PSP. I used to run, like, a really stupid version of, like, Windows XP on my PSP. And it was stupid. Takahushi. He is chilling in fourth. Like how everybody's like together except for me and the Cadillac. We're just like way the fuck ahead. What? Bingles? Oh my god. The things that come out of my mouth. Yeah, they were recycled until FM4 from, well, it was only Forza 2 and 3. I mean, you still have M. Rossi. Also, hello, Cadillac, man. Oh, God, no, Cadillac. No! I've been passed by a Cadillac. That is no bueno, but I can just take him back. Maybe. There we go. Okay, we're good. Also, half a tank of gas hype. God damn it, these puns. Why? Okay, so I'm back in first. Cadillac Man is right behind me. So I know if I do get in second somehow and end up sticking there for more than 2 seconds, I can pass back Mr. Cadillac Man pretty easily because I keep gaining time off of him. Free McBoot. Hey, there was a 007 game that you could use to put the soft mode on the original Xbox also. Which is why, well, I want the Splinter Cell route, not I bought Splinter Cell. One whole big camera view. That'd actually be kinda awesome, except for stupid. Because why not just have windows? A dyslexic man walks into a bra. You have to make poo soon. Good luck with that, Q. Good luck. Oh, balls. I keep fucking up. I'm looking at chat way too much. But there's so much happening. Speaking of money and buying things, I am still waiting. Yesterday, I bought a microphone stand slash boom arm thing, whatever you call it. So I can actually use my wheel and not have my camera or my microphone in a ridiculous position. Oh, bulls. And I ordered an HDMI splitter, so yeah. Because Apple likes me. Yeah. Like, make something that's really simple, like Windows, really stupidly complex and stuff. And you have Apple. Okay, so this is actually gonna be really close to the first or the last race in gas because I'm at roughly under a half a tank with, oh yeah, I forgot about tire wear. How are my tires doing? Not bad, actually. Not as bad as the PT Cruiser was. But also, it was front-wheel drive, and the fact that I was doing a burnout everywhere was not helping. So we're still doing good on tire wear on there, which is nice. Yeah. And we're at a little under half a tank of gas. I could probably actually pit, like, really soon. I'm gonna wait until I get to, like, a quarter of a tank. That feel when there is going to be a pit stop, though. There just won't be one until, like, almost the end of the race, because, hey, turn 10. Also, I'm flying off the track. BRB. I just got air, okay. percent right front wear. Yeah, lap 20. Your tires get fucking wrecked. There's confirmed going to be endurance races in Forza 6. I didn't really hear about any of that. I want to know where you got your information from. Yeah, that's exactly what Antic said. And before GT6 Lincoln Enduros. 24 minutes of Le Mans. Increasing tire and fuel gauge, fuck me. Cadillac Man's gonna pass me. Goodbye, Cadillac Man. How about no Forza GT versus no? Versus no? Forza GT versus no? Yeah, just no. Okay, so I have to catch Mr. Cadillac Man. Which should be fairly easy, because this car fucking sucks at handling. I live in the Midwest. To be more specific, Missouri. Oh, fuck. Bad news bears. Grid did that before, it was cool. I didn't know they grid did it. Okay, I'm gonna be cheeky and fucking just be an asshole. Also, I just wrecked the shit out of my front bumper by doing that. Congratulations, me. Also, goodbye, Mr. Cadillac Man. I'm going to pass you. Fucking asshole. Yeah, get the fuck off my track. Rip. Yeah, so I'm from Missouri, so that makes me a cowboy. I don't know how that logic works. Huh, that's interesting. Cheeky breeky. I don't think I have to worry about Mr. Cadillac Man anymore. Still seem at the whole position he gains in the first. Good job. That is Grid Autosport AI for you. Mad Max Inferno. That's interesting. I'll have to look more into that endurance stuff. Is anybody pit? No, nobody's pitted yet. Everybody's still like on the same lap. Everybody's a cowboy in your heart. Where's Cat? Oh, he's still in second. Holy shit, he actually saved it somehow. Hey, I'm in first though, so suck my dick. Suck me dick. So we're almost two-thirds of the way through. DVD decryptor. Okay, make sure I actually slow down for this turn. So it'll be 2 to 4 hours, that's pretty awesome. That's the kind of endurance of races I want to look forward to. Blah, 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 forwards to. Although I could play through Gran Turismo 5 and or 4 and get to endurance races that way, but you know. That's Gran Turismo. Oh, it's from an interview? Okay. Guess that makes a little more sense to me. 77B. Yeah, I'll have to look up this interview. Is there a specific name of the interview, or what? Need for Speed Underground 2 works like shit on my computer. Yeah, GT Gran Turismo. I say GT like everybody knows what GT is, but not everybody knows what GT is. You can't post a link because of YouTube, not because of me. YouTube is a Nazi and doesn't like links, besides if you're a mod. So that's uno problema. Hello, Shadow. I'd rather not drift because I need my rear tires for things, because hey, endurance. He sucks. Yeah, it's all YouTube's fault. Blame YouTube. Also, Mr. Cadillac Man caught up very quickly. Also, everybody else did too. The drag DLC? There was a drag DLC now that I think about it. I forgot about that. I don't have that. I have, like, the limited edition, whatever. And that's it. Great typewriters. Great. First gear, please, thank you. $12 on the PlayStation Store? Huh. Is there really a Slap Train video as the number one? God damn it. Go away, Slap Train. You have nothing to do with Forza 2 or endurance racing whatsoever. Like, you think one lap of the Nürburgring is an endurance. Seriously, like, what the fuck? Okay, what lap should I pit on? That is a question. Oh, apparently two people did pit on this lap. Okay, so people are gonna start pitting. Show me on Twitter. Okay. I could probably look at it, because I have my stream page, like, the gaming.youtube.com/whatever page, where I can watch my stream up. I just don't have it, like, as my main thing. Black Panther. Goodbye, Cadillac. Holy shit, I think I psyched him out a little bit. Adblock to completely delete YouTube recommendations. Wow. Make him drive on the Autobahn? Oh my god. I want to drive on the Autobahn. I'm going to pit this lap. So you can suck my nerd. Suck my nerd? Nerd laughs in the motor carriage. Cadillac Man is pitting. Ooh. Also, there's an RX-7 back there. Come on, Mustang, go! Where are you guys gonna go? Okay, right behind me. Okay, the two guys that pitted are getting very close. Go, Mustang, go! I don't know. I just assume. Because, like, that's the longest race I've ever seen him do, is one lap of the Nürburgring. Or was it two laps? I don't remember. Also, yes, suck my dick, other people. Okay, so now all I have to do is just wait until the other three guys pit. And, yeah. Sucks lawn chairs. Okay, so now, I gotta just stay on my ground. Make sure. Ooh, Mr. Cadillac Man is actually behind another car. If you hear him say that, he'll block him. He probably has, like, no clue who you are and just block him. I don't think he actually said it, yeah. But like I said, that's the longest race I've ever seen him do, ever. And like, I've done fucking hours of races before. Is that Camaro behind me? I think it is a Camaro. E3 2015. Yeah, I'll definitely stream Forza 6 Endurance. God damn it. Yeah, I'll definitely stream Forza 6 a lot, probably. Probably not right at first or in the demo. Well, I might stream the demo some. I don't know. But for sure, like, at least the endurance races or longer races. Because I'll be recording them anyways, and it's going to be a pain in the ball sack. Also, hello, second place. M. Rossi is the only one that hasn't pitted yet. He's the one baller that hasn't fucking pitted yet. What? I think the Camaro's closing in on me a little bit, which makes me kind of sad. It's probably because I damaged my front bumper. Because I fucking launched off that one area. I love when I shift up and then instantly shift down. PS2 with Underground 2. I wouldn't even want, like, Underground 2 on PS2 because, hey, 480i, and I can't play it on my monitor, my main monitor, because 480i. But I can play it on my Xbox because 480p. Ooh, excuse me. Tastes like ravioli. Toasted ravioli. I still would love to do a playthrough of Need for Speed Underground 2 sometime. But that day is not now. Because I still have to finish Underground 1 and Most Wanted. And various other things. Such as this game, which will be finished before Forza 4, 6 comes out. Shit. Forza 4 came out 2 years ago. Also, rip M. Rossi. He's fucking just... He's gonna get passed by everybody. Oh my god. Yeah, the PS2 is such a powerful console. 40i on every game except for Gran Turismo. Xbox, you have 40p on every single game. No matter if the game support, like, has it on the back or not, it will play in 40p or higher, depending on whatever. Add a good frame rate, too. Well, mostly. Underground 2 is not a very good frame rate. Turds racing and inappropriate things. Exactly. It's mostly racing, but, you know. I don't know. Yeah, I think the PS2 is actually cheaper than the Xbox, which is probably why it sold better. I can't remember exactly why the PS2 sold better than the 40p. Yeah, I say 480p and kind of fast sometimes. It's like 40p, and it sounds like 40p. I apologize if I'm confusing. I've had Need for Speed Underground 2 since like 2005. Could guide missiles? What? Yeah, I think the original Xbox cost more, which is why it didn't sell as good as PS2. Oh god. Also lap 2430 hype. I will look it up if I remember. Screw that corkscrew. DVD, yep. Original Xbox had a DVD. It even came, well, it didn't come with a remote. You had to buy a separate remote and a an IR receiver, whatever, to play DVDs on the original Xbox. But you could do it in 480p. You just had to pay, like, an extra, whatever, $50 or whatever to buy the remote. And it was pretty stupid. But I have one. I don't think it works because the remote doesn't work, I don't think. I don't know. I have it still. I actually have the thing still in my Xbox that picks up the remote's things. It's DVD on Xbox. Hello, Football Rocks. What? People thought it was like super crazy. Wow. 2003? Well, it was 2001 or 2000, depending on if you're thinking of the PS2 or the Xbox. Oh god. Please no slideys, Mustang. Please no slideys. Also, this Camaro is keeping up really well for some reason. Not sure why. Yeah, well, discs we use today are Blu-rays. Well, Blu-rays, yeah. I think the Wii U even uses Blu-rays now. I'm not sure what is. Well, yeah, because the PS3 had a Blu-ray, you didn't have to have two discs to install. Well, there wasn't really a game. Well, I guess Gran Turismo was kind of compared. Gran Turismo 5 and 6 was comparable to Forza 4 in size, maybe even bigger, I don't know. But you didn't need two discs to run Gran Turismo 6, but you needed two discs to run Forza 3 and 4. Yeah, I've played Grid Autosport. I played a lot, actually. Played a lot on online. Online is amazing on it, believe it or not. And everything else is bleh. Xbox sucks, he says, on a Forza Motorsport 2 stream. But yeah, Grid Autosport is fun other than the stupid AI. I had to put the AI in easy or else I'd get fucking wrecked every single time I try and pass any person for any reason on any part of any track. They're so fucking aggressive. Favorite discipline? I don't know. I didn't really get that far through the career. I can't even remember what there was because I haven't played the game in so long. I should probably play it again. Because I haven't played that game in a long time. Probably the last time I played it was when I made the review of it, which was like March of this year, I think. Something like that. Get your fanboy eyes out here. I can't remember. I did like the modern muscle cars a lot. And I don't know. I can't remember many of the other disciplines. All I remember is buying a Mazda RX-7 on the online mode. And that's it. Oh yeah, I remember there was like the front-wheel drive cars, yeah. I'd have to play the game again to really figure out what is good about it and whatever. Yeah, Xbox had the HD DVD system, but they never used it on games because they knew nobody was going to buy the extra fucking CD drive to play HD DVDs. Which is why they stopped selling it after like 2 years. I don't even know if it was, I think it might have been just 1 year after they started making the HD DVD player for 360. They stopped selling it because nobody was buying it. But if you were like Sony and you put it into the console whenever it first came out, it was perfectly fine. And it fucking just got extra popular. Has your waifu in it? Yeah, I remember the 787 being there. Being in there. Autosport is a good game. The physics are good. Like I said, the only thing I'm upset about with it is the, AI. I cannot stand the fucking AI in that game. Also, I think I'm getting a little bit ahead of the AI in this race. A little more than I already was. Also, the Camaro's still in second place. Oh, Jones. The wheel, Grid Autosport actually works really good with the wheel, too. Yeah, I know they got, it was because Sony made it, and they were like, oh, we're just gonna put this in our console. Xbox is Burnout Paradise 2. What? But yeah, I know that Sony was like, oh, this is our technology that we're gonna put in our console. Fuck off, Xbox, pretty much. And then all of a sudden, Blu-ray became like the ultimate source of great quality movies and shit. So yeah, and now everybody's using Blu-ray. Which I think, like I said, I think even Wii U is using Blu-ray, if I remember right. No, my Xbox One has Blu-ray. Because I played, I mean, I know for sure it does because I've played Blu-rays in it, but it is not exclusive anymore. But it was, I think, until, I don't know. I guess really until this generation of consoles came out, it was all Sony. Xbox is Burnout Paradise 2. I don't understand what that means, but that's what you're saying. Hey, I'm getting further ahead. I like the looks of this, even though I only have 2 laps left. I mean, I bet Microsoft probably paid Sony like a metric fuck ton of money to get Blu-ray, as it did Nintendo. And various CD or whatever Blu-ray drive people did for PC stuff, because you can buy a Blu-ray player for your PC. And all the other Blu-ray player companies and stuff like that. I think after a certain point, Sony's like, fuck it. We'd make a lot more money on this. I think they figured they would make a lot more money on it by, like, saying, oh, anybody can use Blu-ray. Because probably the money's still going to Sony from me buying an Xbox One disc. The dorm plumbing room? Nice. Wait. Dorm plumbing room? What? Plumbing system. God, I am blind, dyslexic, and tired. Apparently. Because really, Blu-ray is like the ultimate. Besides downloads, Blu-ray is the ultimate, ultimate sort way of doing things. It's better work. Well, hi, RKD. Welcome to the stream. Sandwich. Just came back just in time for the last lap. which is coming up in like 10 seconds. Last lap hype. I am pretty far ahead. 3.8 seconds, not bad. Sure, it isn't two laps like the last one, but chemist signs of exhaustion. Blindness, dyslexia, slurred words, and the list goes on. John Cena? John Cena! I'm a fucking SpongeBob thing. Where he's about to say he's a goofy goober, and he's like, I'm... And then, all of a sudden, John Cena! Meatloaf? Meatloaf is a good band, yes. I guess I make a lot of right turns on Xbox One. Or Xbox 360, goddammit. Because the whole entire right side of my left thumbstick is worn off, but the left side isn't. I am not Rhino, apparently. I make less left turns than right turns. Or my thumb just kind of sits in that particular spot. I don't know. Also, final corner hype. Of the C-Class Endurance. Okie dokie, I shall check the tweeters. Did not work, Junior. It does not seem like it worked. Okie dokie. That is the red screen. That's no good. That is the C-Class Endurance race done. Swaggin'. 183,000 credits. I lost 11,000 from taking flight and wrecking my my front bumper. Yeah, I'm level, whatever. Yeah, max level. Ford, yeah. Okay. Takahashi. Okay. Oh god, the cancer. It's old cancer, too. Hey, Lamau, I did it. Boarded the Acura? Wait, does that give me all the That does give me all the American cars. Did I get the achievement already? I wasn't paying attention. Yeah, it looks completely fine. Wait, did I get the achievement? Was I... No, maybe I didn't. Hold on. DVDR. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know about that. Anyways, that is the end of that. So next we'll be doing the A-Class at Silverstone. We're going to win a Bentley Speed 8. And then all these other ones and all that kind of stuff. And things and stuff. What kind of percentage are we at? 92%. Of course, it's going up by 1% each episode. But I want to see. Hold the phone. Hold the fuck on. Okay, so I have all of those, including DLC cars. I'm not leaving yet. I'm gonna still stream some stuff after this. Oh, there's a Viper, duh. I forgot there was another Viper. That, well, if you're just leaving Antics, then see ya. I'm just saying I'm not gonna end streaming right now. But I will have the achievement, like, later. So, yeah. So this will be the end of the video. I'm probably gonna do some things in the stream afterwards, so if you're watching the stream, then you can stay and be happy and things. So if you're on YouTube watching this, thanks for watching, and I will be back next episode with stuff and things.